Good morning.
Miles.
Members.
Good morning to the world.
For this is the day that the Lord has made. We want to rejoice and be glad in it. We got so much wrong in our world, what's wrong in our life. We want to rejoice. Because the word of God says in all things, give God thanks and praise.
Yes.
Our call to worship this morning is coming from the book of Colossians, chapter 3, verse 16. Colossians, chapter 3, verse 16. And it reads as follows. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, in all wisdom, teaching and admonishing one another, in songs and hymns, and in spiritual songs, singing with grace in your hearts to the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray. Eternal Lord, just once again, we come to thank you for all your many blessings. Thank you for this day that you have made. Thank you for allowing us, Lord, to rise this morning because you touched us with the family of Lord. We thank you, Lord. Today, Lord, we ask you, Lord, to be with us in what we're trying to do here. We ask you, Lord, to lead us and guide us as we journey. Father, we just ask you to look upon each one of our lives. Father, if you see anything that's not pleasing in your sight, Father, Lord, we ask you to forgive us and have mercy on us, because mercy fits each one of our cases. God, we're thankful for life. We're thankful for the people that you have put in our lives. We thank you for this place, this building called Mount Zion. We thank you for all the members that it takes to make up this household of faith. Father, we're not getting together and physically together. Wow, we're going to come together. As your word said, for the sake of not the sin that set us together in small group. But Father, we're still trying to come together through the airways. And so, Father, we just ask you to bless those that are listening on the telephone, those that are watching us on the TV airways. Lord, bless them, Lord. And we pray, Lord, as we do what we do here, that they will feel your presence, Lord. That we'll be blessed for what we do. Father, God, we just ask you to bless all the children that's a part of this ministry, children all over the world. We ask you, Lord, to visit those that are sick this morning. Those that are laying on their beds of affliction, Lord. We just ask you to reach out and touch each one of them, Lord. Heal them and deliver them, Lord. Then, Father, we thank you for our mothers that make this part of this church and for all of us. We thank you for the leaders. We thank you for all the members. We thank you for everybody, Lord. Father God, we ask you this morning to touch our pastor, build it all the way to me. Strengthen him, Lord. Give him preaching down to his soul. Cause him to preach the word this morning without fear or pain, Lord. Declare your truth for your word. You said if you be lifted, we will draw all things unto you. So, Father, as you preach your word and lift you higher, we ask you, Lord, to let your word go out and accomplish that that is sent to do. And, Father, we pray this morning for our city government. We pray for this city of Atlanta who has reached numbers untold for this epidemic that's going on. Ask you to bless this man, touch your family, Lord. Let your healing virtue flow upon her body, Lord. Father, Lord, you know what she feels here. She had a lot on the shoulder, Lord. Then, Father, we pray for all the surroundings in the metro area. Pray for all those that are in trouble. And then, Lord, we lift our presence before you. Those that are around him, Father, we just ask you to touch their minds, touch their hearts, that they'll have minds and hearts of compassion for the people, Lord. Father, Lord, we pray for the whole world. Pray for both that are lost and our Lord, you in the free possible of their sin. Pray, Lord, this morning that this message go out, this service go out, that someone, Lord, surrender their lives to you, Lord. Our scripture reading this morning, John 3:16. John 3:16. And read this part. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. The word of God for the people of God.
Amen.
Thank you.
preaching before the congregation.
Yes.
Well, there are just a few people here. We work with the Holy Ghost and to assist us musically. church say amen.
Amen.
We thank Minister Williams sharing with us again today. It's good to know that when we enter the prayer meetings,
yes,
the Lord will.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Yes, yes.
Amen. Praise be to God. I want to just read a few verses of scripture. The first is found in the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 4. It was not to evoke a lot of inspiration, but it was experience and perspiration. It is the gospel, the word in working clothes. But Jesus sets forth the core of the Christian faith.
Yes.
He deals with the manifesto of the kingdom of God.
Well,
or if you want to put it in a more contemporary context, he is dealing with what I like to call the God movement.
Yes.
Yes.
The God movement. Now, this is the body of thought.
Uh-huh.
The judging principles.
Uh-huh.
Which form, shape, correct,
uh-huh,
and direct,
uh-huh,
the new order of the faithful.
Yes.
It gives them substance.
Uh-huh.
In fact, it gives character.
Yes.
It provides identity. In fact, Jesus felt that the whole Christian movement,
uh-huh,
stands or falls in stark reference to this dazzling and wonderful lecture that he gives in the Gospel of Matthew.
Yes.
Chapter 7.
Yes.
Verses 24 through 27.
Yes.
Jesus was seeking to infuse,
yeah,
his followers with some meaningful and helpful ideas.
Yeah.
The Jews, you will remember, considered themselves to be a theocracy,
uh-huh,
through which God spoke to the people.
Yes.
So Jesus had to be a representative,
uh-huh,
of God, living God's platform.
Yes.
To God's people.
Yes.
And while Jesus presented this as he did, and he did it, as I stated earlier, for his movement, there were certain things that he had to reject.
Yeah.
Certain ideas,
uh-huh,
that had been thrown at him. And he had to examine whatever those ideas thrown at him might have been.
Yes.
Some he would discard,
mm-hmm,
and some perhaps he would hold on to.
Yes.
In order to see the struggle, he went through to get rid of the bad.
Yes.
He took the time,
uh-huh,
to get rid of bad stuff.
Yes.
And I want you to look with me in this fourth chapter of Matthew embark upon this new ministry. He has to make it crystal clear to the people that certain ideas would not be a part of this new movement. And then Jesus was brought up in the wilderness by the Spirit to be tempted of the devil. Now, the word translated devil is diabolos in the Greek. It comes from dia, meaning around through, and bola, meaning to throw. Alright? So diabolos, meaning one who throws things about. One who stirs things up. One who causes confusion. That's the devil's work. And the evil one really takes a strong step. But he will raise some questions as well. In fact, he takes a strong stand on the one hand, but he's very crafty in raising a key question. And so that's how the devil operates. He's like a snake. You remember the snake in the garden said to Eve, as God said not to eat of that tree. Now notice he didn't say don't eat of the tree. No, he didn't say that. But he didn't say, you know, go ahead. He just raised the question. That's all he had to do. And the work of the devil, as I'm saying today, is this. He likes to confuse the mind. And he's out there to muddy the water. For himself, where he can't really see clearly, you know, any of those issues. But the record says when he had passed, talking about Jesus, 40 days, and 40 nights. Then he was hungry. And the devil showed up big time and said, if you are God's son, if you are who you claim to be, tell these rocks that they should become loaves of bread. Turn these stones into bread. If you are God's son. This statement has nothing to do with really divinity. It has nothing really to do with the deity of Jesus. This, my brothers and sisters, is a political statement. Jesus, when living under what the Jews called a theocracy, ruled by Actually, about the same thing as saying, if you want to be president, say of the United States, it has nothing to do with getting old. Deity. No person running for president. That ain't got a thing to do with deity.
Yeah.
Am I right?
Yes, sir.
But it does have something to do with one's right to lead if elected.
Yeah.
But if you're going to rule, you're going to be the leader of this movement.
Yeah.
That Jesus is talking about. The devil says to him, turn these stones to bread.
Yeah.
Now, what really was the proposition? To get him a little piece of bread and break his fast. And what he was trying to get Jesus to do? No, this was not an appeal to Jesus' fleshly appetite. You know, Jesus had already fasted.
Yeah.
40 days and 40 nights. And you don't break a fast with bread when you've been fasting that long. And by faith, the confusion, the devil, was saying, now Jesus, you want these people and you want to be the leader of a new movement. People out here are hungry everywhere.
Yes.
That's a bad situation. They don't have jobs, they're unemployed.
Yeah.
People are all crying for bread.
Yes.
And it sounds like America, doesn't it?
Yes.
Now, if you want to be the head of your movement, make it a bread movement.
Yeah.
Make bread as plentiful in Palestine.
Yeah.
As the stars are.
Uh-huh.
So the devil tempted Jesus, trying to engage in a movement of materialism.
Yes.
Atheistic. Materialism. And such as we saw even in Moses. What we see on Wall Street.
Yeah.
I'm telling you, we have much to understand.
Yeah.
That life consists minds of many in this nation, including our so-called president.
Yes.
The abundance of things. You know, he's on that, the more you get, the merrier you'll be. I'm not so sure he was all in on providing the stimulus packages for the poor.
No.
But he knew that might bring him some votes.
Yeah. Said.
Don't be fooled.
Don't be fooled.
My brothers and sisters, there's something that the devil was saying here. He was saying really to Jesus, let prosperity run down like water.
Yeah.
And economic abundance. Like a mighty stream.
Yeah.
Jesus, if you can do that, I think you can get the nomination to be the head of the government.
Yeah.
And Jesus rejected it.
Uh-huh.
And said, no, by bread alone.
Yes, sir.
But by every word proceeding out of the mouth of God.
Yeah.
Then the devil does something else.
Uh-huh.
He decides to take him into the holy city.
Yeah.
And he sets him on the pillar of the temple.
Uh-huh.
And says, now if you are God's son, if you really want to be the head of this God movement, then throw yourself down.
Yeah.
For it is written, he shall give his angels charge over thee, lest thou dash thy foot against the stone.
Yeah.
They'll carry you safely along. You won't have anything to worry about.
Yeah.
Unless you worried about something you told, you have no worries. You don't have to worry about that. Now the pendulum begins to swing. And it swings to the opposite extreme in the proposal.
Yeah.
And the proposal was mere materialism.
Yes.
Jesus clearly rejected that. And then, like I said, the devil is cracked. He decides to do something else. He says, listen, I need to swing the pendulum.
Yeah.
Some kind of way. And in favor of speech, Jesus is taken to the holy city.
Yeah.
And the holy city is located in what is often referred to as the holy hill.
Yeah.
And the holy land. And it was really situated in the holy hill. And the devil takes things into the holy temple, which is in the center of the holy city.
Yes.
And he takes him up to the pinnacle of the temple. And this leads me to say that you have to be careful. You can't get any holier than that. You're at the top of holiness now. You are at the jumping off place. And that is exactly what Satan says to Jesus.
Yeah.
Now, Jesus, I know it's true. You might not want this stuff that you refer to as materialism. You may not want that. And, I see that you are more spiritual man. Yeah, you're operating in a spiritual sense. So let's set up a big spiritual offer. I want to offer you something spiritual.
Yeah.
You can be the head of this vast ecclesiastic gathering, you'll be the executive director.
Yeah.
Put it that way.
Uh-huh.
You'll be the executive director of the executive committee of the World Council of Churches. And maybe even the World Baptist Alliance. If you don't want to be, Donald Trump, maybe you want to be the Pope.
Yeah.
I got just the thing. I got the right offer.
Yeah.
You'll be the head. theology.
Come on.
Or not, it won't matter.
It won't matter.
And you will have the power to do what you want.
Yes.
And they'll establish you in such a way that if you follow my instructions, you'll be like right in there. And if they catch you, if they try to do something, they gonna get jammed in the process. But you have to understand, you can issue any kind of paper or water, you can go on the court.
Yeah.
And it'll go through. You can do anything you want to do. You're infallible.
Yeah.
You don't have a movement of materialism, my brothers and sisters. Like that. But the devil is saying, be the head.
Be the head.
A great churchman.
Yeah.
And Jesus rejects him on that.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
And says, quite frankly, don't try, you know, me like this.
Uh-huh.
Don't try to come to me with some of your messed up theology. God, you see, did not come to set up an ecclesiastical structure. No, this has really got Satan in the dilemma now. In fact, the Lord has jammed him.
Uh-huh.
He doesn't know what to do or where to go. And he's gone. Really, his limit is going all the way from pure materialism to ecclesiasticism. And now, finally, he says, I got, you know, just one thing that you want. And this is a habit. You know, the truth is somewhere between the two extremes. So he takes Jesus up to a high mountain.
Yes.
Yes. Takes him up to a high mountain.
Yes.
And he saw the points out all the kingdoms.
Yes.
Of the whole world.
Yeah.
And he points out these kingdoms that are dazzling with glory.
Yeah.
He says to Jesus, I'm in a position to give you all of this. I can give you all of this. And you will have this with all the glory. If you just fall down, that's all you got to do. Just fall down and worship me. And he says, I want you to understand, I'm really a king maker. I can make you a king. I can do something for you.
Yeah.
That you can't do for yourself.
Yes.
And I can pull some strength on your behalf. You don't have to pull the strength. I can pull the strength.
Yes.
You're trying, young man, from what I can tell, you seem to be a nice fellow. But you have to understand that you're just, you know, a bit younger than Julius Caesar.
Yeah.
And you're just great social concern for people, you would make a much better emperor.
Come on.
You would make a Jesus says, look, get moving.
Get moving.
Get thee behind me.
Yes, sir.
Sin.
Yeah.
That's what Jesus said.
Uh-huh.
He makes it very clear. So Jesus rejected three mightiest ideas that had been for the mind of man.
Yeah.
Materialism.
Uh-huh.
Ecclesiasticism.
Uh-huh.
And militarism. These three could absolutely have no part in the movement of Jesus. So having tested all of these big pleas, Jesus turns to setting up his own movement. But before he could do it, he had to have a father. And he had to have people who would lend themselves to such an idea.
Yes, sir.
You may have great ideas in the absence of no one willing to follow.
Preach.
They have to take flesh.
Yeah.
Good ideas have to take form. Jesus had to have a body of people.
Yeah.
However large, however small, who would sort of share his ideas, his convictions, and lend themselves to his move.
Yes, sir.
So immediately, after rejecting these ideas, which could not be part of his movement, he turns his attention to finding a body of people who would lend themselves to the new idea, which he would present to them.
Yeah.
And from them, Jesus began to cry out and say, simply repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Change your whole way of thinking. For you are now confronted with the new order of God's great and glorious movement. A whole new way of thinking is now upon you.
Yes, sir.
Change your whole way of thinking. And join in with this new. And so he called the 12 into service.
Yes, sir.
And among them was Peter, James, and John. Matthew, to name a few. And you think that Matthew would have been an unfaithful choice for a man who's trying to get a popular movement. So, you know, Matthew was one of those popular men of Jesus' day. He was a publican. He was a tax collector for the Romans. And to top it off, he chose a guy by the name the zealot. Now we know the crowd of zealots. No king, they say, except Jehovah. No lawgiver but Moses. And no tax but the temple tax. Can you really understand patriotism on a higher plane? All you would have to do is strike up one line of singing a song like Dixie. And those Republicans would be out there waving the Confederate flag.
Watch out.
Now Jesus, Jesus chose Matthew, the prophet, and Satan, Simon, the zealot. And Jesus could make Simon and Matthew part of those 12 who would follow him. And he would give such assignments to them that they could walk down the main street in Jerusalem, holding hands, and calling one another brother. The God movement was underway.
Amen.
Jesus was trying to make it crystal clear that a living demonstration was taking place because of the God movement. My brothers and my sisters, when God starts moving, the devil has to get away. When God sets his plan, the devil may try all kinds of schemes to block, to impede, and even try to rat in the life. Make it sound like he can do something to help you along. But you have to be careful. You have to be discerning. Just like the Lord. And when the Lord understands, and when you have his mind, you can deal with the devil. And you can simply say, devil, get me back. You can talk all you want to, but you can't change my idea. My idea is you. He's the one who can set me free. My loyalty is to Christ and not to the country. My loyalty is to the king. Not some president. Stationed up there in Washington. My allegiance is to God. Because God is.
Yes, he is.
He is. My king.
Yes, sir.
He is the ultimate ruler of the whole universe.
Yes, he is.
So my brothers and sisters,
hallelujah.
Take the lesson. Take the lesson. From the Sermon on the Mount. Don't get caught up in materialism. Don't get caught up in Ecclesiastes. Don't get caught up by the devil himself. Because he's there. Not for your good. Not for your gain. He's there to put you off course. And to get you to follow him. To help make other disciples for him. So Christ is more than the devil. Could ever hope to be.
Christ
has all power. Do I have a witness?
Christ
is our rock. And our salvation. So it is in that spirit. That we offer Christ to you on this day. God bless you. May the Lord touch the hearts of those who already recognize that they need somebody better than what the devil can offer. I'm telling you, nobody can do you like Jesus. Yield not to temptation.
Oh, I can do
the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
Rest, move, and abide with us today, tomorrow,